Good day, everybody. Are you all ready for today's help session? Yes. The topic for today is decision making. Let's start with a humorous video which gives a lot of inputs on today's topic. As questions are posed, few can raise their hands and give their responses. Why did Mr. D come to the bank? How many counters were there in the bank? Did Mr. D stand in front of only one counter? Why did he move from one counter to another? Could he finally draw the money? Was he a good decision maker? Are we facing similar situations every time, every day in our lives? What time to get up? What should we wear? What food to eat? When should we study? So on and so forth. It's mind-boggling. The choices for each situation are many, and we struggle to arrive at a decision. Isn't it, friends? Decision-making is an action or process of identifying and choosing alternatives based on various factors. We will discuss the process one needs to follow to arrive at a right decision. Decision-making process involves 6 main steps. Firstly, identifying the problem. Next, analyzing the problem. Developing alternative solutions. Selecting the best solution. Converting decision into action. And last but not the least, follow up for the action taken. Let's have an activity to understand these 6 steps. We will now start the session with recall and reflection. Suppose you are posed with this question. You had a choice of multiple subject groups offered in class 11. After class 10 exams, or even before that, what made you choose your particular subject group? Reflect for 20 seconds and then we will have 5 of you sharing your responses with the whole class. This is a case study. Let us see how we can apply the process we learned just now on a real life situation. Now, let's understand the steps you must have adopted in arriving at a decision in choosing your particular group. The problem that you had was the number of groups offered in many colleges and you had to choose only one. This is called identifying the problem, the first step. Now, let us move to step 2, that is to analyze the problem. To analyze the problem means to understand the advantages and disadvantages of selecting the groups and colleges. Pose the WH questions to do the analysis. What, where, when, why, who, and how. For example, what is the quality of education offered? Where is it located? Who will help me? How far is it? Etc. Step 3 is to develop alternate solutions. I must have an order of preference, as I may not be able to get the group of my choice or the college I prefer. If I don't get a particular group or college, I must plan for the next best. If I still don't get the best, I must plan to move to another city or hostel, etc. Once we develop alternate solutions, now we have to select the best out of our alternate solutions which we have planned. If plan A is not feasible, we select plan B. And even that does not materialize, we must have to move to plan C. Some of you must have faced this situation, right, friends? Step 5. Once the selection and the right decision is taken, we must now spring into action. That is, to complete the admission process in this case. There seems to be a sense of finality when we complete the step 5, but it is not so. We still have a very important step at the end, follow up for our action taken. This gives us an opportunity to review our decision, maybe within a month or so, based on our personal experience. For example, either to continue or look for another option if you think it is better. Hope you all have understood this 6 key steps in making a decision. Train your mind to stay calm in every situation. But how? Do deep breathing. More oxygen will flow to your brain, helping in clarity of thoughts. You can practice relaxation or meditation, maybe for 10 or 15 minutes. This relaxes the body and calms the mind. We must understand that decision making is an intellectual capability as well as a psychological and biological capability. Therefore, friends, don't take decisions when you are hungry, angry, lonely, or tired. Follow the halt principle. Just halt. Why? Because these are the times when we are most likely to make mistakes and regret the wrong decision taken. Decisions are the hardest to make, especially when it's a choice between what you want and what is right. For example, it's exam time and your friend calls you for a movie. It may be what you want, but what is right is to say politely no and study for the exam. our head thinks while our heart feels. Our hearts will give us the best and the right answers. You may want to bunk a class, but deep within there is the feeling that you must attend. Therefore, do what is right and not what you want. Friends, when in doubt, refer to your heart. The heartfulness tools of meditation and cleaning will help you to connect to your heart. Heart will only signal what is right. This is the only choice. When you listen to your heart, you will automatically do what is right. Let's end the session on a lighter note. There was this ant on the river bank. She had a problem. She had to cross the river to meet her dearest friend on the other bank. She analyzed the problem and thought of alternate solutions. Suddenly, she saw leaves from this bank floating on the river. She immediately found this to be the best solution. She sprung into action by jumping onto one such leaf. Sitting on the leaf, she crossed the river and reached the other bank safely. All that she did was to follow the decision-making steps to solve her problem. Isn't it she very smart? So are we, friends. We need to make fresh decisions to solve problems at the right time. This will be the sixth step in decision making. Reviewing it till we complete the task. Remember that decision making process is continuous and dynamic. Let's recap all that we have learned till now. Decision making is a skill and it has a process. Staying calm and being relaxed. Using the halt decisions. When in doubt, referring to your heart. All these are the wonderful tips which we can use for making an effective decision in our day-to-day lives. Friends, knowing is not enough. Start making decisions the right way, wherever and whenever you need to. We will all meet you once again next week with a new topic. Thank you and have a wonderful day. Goodbye, friends.